In a season that lasts from August to the end of February, routine is essential to maintaining focus. Bodies are crafted for speed, explosion, and the ability to fly. Fingers are taped, knees and ankles are braced, and laces are tightened. An aptitude to process information and unleash power at will is vital for a game of grace and finesse. In a game where the difference between a joyous celebration and complete disappointment is ultimately two errors, the game of volleyball has turned individuals into sport junkies, with volleyball running through their minds at all hours of the day. For those who let it take over their being, it is part of their daily routine and the passion for it courses through their veins. Volleyball is not part of the mainstream in North America, and finding games usually takes countless hours of hunting matches down at 4 a.m. Volleyball players are special. They have embraced a game that has not been widely accepted in North America. There are not any pro teams, and the highest level of competition you can achieve is at the varsity level. Located in southwestern Ontario, a gritty blue-collar town with history tied to the automotive industry, Windsor is the furthest city south in Canada and sits south of Detroit, Michigan. Just to the east of the busiest border crossing in the world sits the University of Windsor. A tiny school with only 13,000 undergraduates with state-of-the-art facilities. The St. Denis Center is the coliseum that is home to some of the country's best athletes. The University of Windsor athletics program has been on the fast track to greatness over the last 5 years. National titles in track and field is religion, and basketball has tasted success with women's basketball national title in 2011. The University of Windsor took a chance on hiring local volleyball coach Shawn Lippert, made a CIS All-Star and small-town-rooted Kyle Williamson, and took on Ontario All-Star Blasé Wasser, who has been told time and time again that he was too short to set in the OUA. The Lancer men's volleyball program is much like the city they are products of, not afraid of hard work and doing what it takes. Rising from disparity, and not using excuses as leverage for almost. Just 3 years ago, they were 5-15 with 5 graduating seniors. They are now a team with an intensity to upsurge through the OUA and CIS. This is the story of the Lancer men's volleyball team and how they prepare for one day. Through the eyes of 3 underdogs, a first-year coach, a hometown veteran, and a bright-eyed rookie. This is Lancer Pride. Born and raised in Windsor, Shawn Lippert is no stranger to the volleyball world. In 1992, he started from the ground up with his high school volleyball team and succeeded at every level over 18 years. This is his first head coaching position. He is also no stranger to passion as shown with his widely covered proposal and marriage to his wife Colleen, which went worldwide with news coverage. His day begins as always, with a bagel and coffee en route to the office. He will then prepare for the game day serve-receive. Upon arrival, he is visited by women's volleyball head coach Lucas Hodgson to discuss the status of French import Timothy Jamel.
Is Timo in school now?
We're waiting. We're going to find out exactly.
Today?
Today.
He won't be able to dress tonight.
What's that? Oh, yeah. He'll dress tonight.
You have him on the roster with Lisa and everything already?
Well, Adam, like, last minute. He's got to be able to get in. He's got to register for his classes first, right? So he gets his 3 classes. Yeah. Boom. He's in. We can throw him in late.
Blasé Wasser is a tenacious rookie out of Burlington, Ontario. Burlington, much like Windsor and its blue-collar roots, specializes in steel distribution. Wasser was picked up not just for his volleyball skills as a premier setter in Ontario, but also for his attitude and his good-natured outlook on life. Last season, he played for the Waterloo Club team, as well as Team Ontario. Coach Lippert and Wasser have history together, as Coach Lippert was his volleyball coach on the Region 3 team made up of the best 16U volleyball players in the province. Together, they helped the team win a gold medal at the regional games in 2009.
Got it on the footage right now.
It's on footage. Uh-oh, we got Coos?
It's Coos. Where? Coos!
What's up, Coos?
Coos. Hey, buddy.
What's up, guys? It's been too long, Coosie.
With the camera, I know.
Absolutely. McDonald's coffee in the AM.
It's 10 a.m., and practice gets underway. Team captain, Kyle Williamson, has still not arrived, and practice goes on without him.
7 for 15. Not very good.
Come on, guys, the pass is terrible right now. Let's go.
Like when you said you felt so happy. At 10:15, Williamson arrives and hustles to get ready. He quickly joins his team. Told myself that you were right for me, but felt so lonely in your company. But that was love, and it's an ache I still remember. Serving is still an issue for the team. They remain very inconsistent. After two missed serves, the team must run suicides before continuing practice.
Better now to get it out of your system than to have it happen tonight. Get focused, it's game day.
So when we found that we could not make sense, well, you said that we would still be friends. But I'll admit that I was glad.
Hey, what I like about that practice there is that you guys play with a lot of confidence. Totally different than where we were in Chicago. Totally different. It was like a different team. That's good that we got a game day. It's bad in the sense that that happens. We're kind of schizo that way. We're one team against another team and then we're another. If we play like that all the time, we'll win a lot more games, boys. That's what we need to work on. That's what we're going to work on. It's everything upside in your head right now. All right, bring it in.
Really good job.
Passing the screen, boys.
Lance, three, two, three.
Lancers. Dinner at 5. I guess you guys are bringing your own stuff.
After practice, Blaze is responsible for putting the team balls away. Rookies are the ones who do the grunt work on the team. Eventually, they will have their own rookies, but for now, it is his turn. After, it's time for the players to stretch and then go on their way until they regroup for dinner.
I really like the guys on the team. They really take you in if you're a rookie, and they really treat you as one of their own. I find some of the older guys, like Will, because Will, one thing, is the other setter on the team, and he has a lot of experience being a fifth year and a couple years older than me. I find I tend to look up to Will a lot, and Kyle, actually, probably the two most influential people on me right now, because those are probably the most two that have taken me in on the team and taught me the ropes.
Blaze's game day routine starts with lunch before he goes for an early afternoon power nap. He begins with the fuel he'll need to get through the day.
It's hot. Can I get a quad club on white bun?
The food that we were eating if we're living on campus is a lot different than if we were living off campus, where we'd be buying our own food, but it's really tough to control what to eat and when we can eat, because there's only certain times that they can be open.
Sorry about the whole camera thing. Mozzarella, please.
I know myself and Lane, another rookie, are living in Carchet, and there's certain restaurants that are open that aren't open all day, so we have to really hustle and get into those ones to get good food.
For the past 4 days, the team traveled to Chicago, Illinois, and played some NCAA teams. They spent 11 hours on the train yesterday, which led to early fatigue for a lot of the players. Blaze is no exception. After lunch, it is time for the second part of his game day routine, a nap.
I don't really have any big patterns. I usually wake up, make a good breakfast. Today we had the service eve, so I went and did that. And usually a good nap midday. And then pretty much nothing. Anything that requires nothing is what I do, because I don't want to get tired at all. School takes up a good chunk of time. I study quite a bit. I take school pretty serious. Hang out with my family, hang out with my girlfriend. I'm not too much of a go out kind of guy. I don't go out very much, like downtown, stuff like that. Not really my thing. So pretty much school and family, my girlfriend takes up all my time. But that's the way that I like it. Nothing else I want to do.
Kyle Williamson is from a small town of 5,000 just east of Windsor, Ontario. A local farming community that is the hub of the county and ground zero for agriculture distribution. A son of a fire chief, Williamson is not afraid of being held to the fire as the team captain. Last year, he was the OUA MVP and the only CIS All-Canadian out of his conference. A quiet star in his high school volleyball season, he flew under the radar of all OUA coaches.
This is my house, this is my living room. Christmas tree, still going. Just generic living room. Here's some Christmas presents I got. I'm a psych major, like I said. This is Sigmund Freud, Carl Jung, Time magazine covers. I really wanted those for Christmas. My parents got them for me, nice and framed. They'll be up in my room and hopefully in my office someday. We'll start upstairs. My mom's a pretty big Christmas decorator, as you can see up there. Kitchen, pretty generic. Fridge, we'll go through that later. All this kind of stuff. Some family pictures. Me, mom, dad, brother. These two are identical, and me and my mom are identical. Just an office. Pretty generic. Nothing special. My dad, as you can see, this is my dad here. It's an old picture of him, but my dad's a fire chief out in Lakeshore. So that's what he is, he's a full-time fire chief. My mom's, she runs the school bus companies here. So I was always the first to know when school was canceled. Downstairs, this is probably the most used room in the house. TV that my dad loves, big TV. Generic kind of room, parents bought stuff up. This is a picture I got a long time ago, actually my parents bought it for my birthday. Kind of a cool, just almost like a poem, but not as wussy, I would like to think. But just about volleyball, it actually speaks quite a bit of truth about the game of volleyball, which is cool to see, because you can't really find a lot of pictures like this about volleyball and stuff. So it's kind of cool. Some awards my mom keeps out. I don't like that she keeps that kind of stuff out, though. It's a pretty cool picture. A friend of mine drew it when we first made playoffs. This is my second year we made playoffs for the first time in, I don't know, probably 5 years in the program. Kind of a cool picture. They used to always joke that I was like Juggernaut from the X-Men because they used to say that I was good enough, but my head was always the thing that ruined my game, which is still pretty true. I just get in my own head and then I suck.
Coach Lippert phones a colleague about the status of Timo's test results.
Hi, Jenny. It's Shawn Lippert calling. We're just calling because we're anxious to find out to see how Timo did. We don't even know if you can find out or not, but we're anxious and he's anxious too. So, all right. Call me back. Thanks. Bye.
We are waiting for my result for my English test because I am French, so I should pass an English test before to enter the university and to play for the team. So I am just waiting the result. If I pass my test, I can play. If I failed, I should wait the next year to be a player for the Lancer Volleyball. It's complicated because I don't know if I will play or not. I should be ready to play if I can, but it's very difficult to be ready for a game because maybe I will be only sit on the bench and it's very, very hard.